Season preview with softball head coach Jamie Stanclift. Jamie, just first things first, just the off season. Some of the things you've accomplished this off season. What have you kind of been doing? What's been going on over in the field house? How's the off season been going?
It has been hectic every day. It seems like we've had a curveball just between COVID and weather, but that's the nature of things, and we've been rolling with the punches. I really love the way that this group has been so resilient, and they roll with it, and they just kind of take it all in stride. We've actually yet to have a practice where we have everybody on the field and able to participate, so that's very unique. But when they are out there, when they're not in class or they're not held back due to COVID quarantines and whatnot, they are really making the most of the opportunities, and we've had really, really productive practices, so that's what's important. As far as other things, you know, recruiting's been going well. We've made some facility improvements. We actually are just finishing up resurfacing our field, infield and bullpen. And so that has been really, really a difference maker. It's going to be great to play on that new surface this spring. It's going to help with drainage and weather issues, and it's going to help the ball play better in the infield, which I'm sure our infielders appreciate. Mm-hmm. And then we've been doing more with mental health this year as well, and working on the mental side of things and building some mental tools that I think will certainly carry over to the field.
Just kind of going into a little bit of the roster itself, some of the newcomers, I know you said you haven't really been able to get everybody all at the same time, but how have they kind of fit in with the group, and is there maybe one or two players that you're looking forward to seeing their freshman year and maybe expecting a decent amount in their first year?
Absolutely. Very strong new group this year. Small but mighty. We've got four newcomers. Three are freshmen. One is a transfer. Our transfer, Savannah Lampley, has brought a whole new personality and spunk to the team. I'm sure that you've heard about that in talking with some of the other girls on the team. But she's our team entertainment at times, but also when it's time to lock in and work, she knows it's time, and so as a coach I certainly appreciate that. She keeps things light, but then she gets the work done. She is going to certainly provide some leadership and experience in the outfield. She swings it from the left side, and she's just been a great fit just instantly when she joined us. Three freshmen are all certainly capable of significant contribution this year. We have Hannah Stevens. She will spend a lot of time behind the plate and swings a big bat. We have Haley Scott, who will see time in the circle and is very fun to watch her compete. She hits for herself too and provides a lot of power. And then we have Savannah Brooks from right here near Wingate, local kid who has worked her butt off to come back from an injury from surgery. And in the fall, she was kind of maybe a step and a half slow, but she worked really, really hard and came back this January back up to speed, probably even better than she was before the injury. She can play anywhere because she's a true athlete. We'll probably see the bulk of her time in the middle infield, and she's a very tough out at the plate, and so we're excited about those newcomers.
Kind of on the other end of that, who've stepped up as leaders, either upperclassmen or otherwise, that maybe weren't filling that role last year?
We have a junior class that kind of naturally feels the most comfortable being vocal leaders, I would think, just because they've been here a few years and they've played under me for a few years now, so they're very clear on the standards and expectations, and their leadership has really helped, and I appreciate their leadership. But I think another thing that's special about this group is that with us having no seniors, I see our freshmen and our sophomores also not being as hesitant or reserved, and being more willing to step up, and it happened to be that they're not afraid to step on any toes since we don't have seniors. And so I really like how on any given day, any given moment, I think that everybody on the team is comfortable speaking up, saying what needs to be said, and that's what it should be, because you don't have to be a senior to be a leader. You have to care about the culture. You have to care about doing things right. That's what makes leadership.
kind of going back to what you were talking about, some of those mental health sessions that you had in the off season, what were you trying to achieve with that, and what type of response have you seen from the players from those sessions that you've had?
Well, I think just in observing and talking individually with some of our student athletes, they are dealing with more as student athletes now in today's world, certainly than I ever dealt with. And so I wanted to try to just provide them some tools and conversation, and just a platform to be heard and to express some of the things that they're going through. And have just some really open dialogue as a team. And in that, it's brought us closer together. We see that we're not alone in our struggles. Being a student athlete is difficult. You've got to manage a lot and balance your time and your priorities. But also in the game of softball, we deal with a lot of failure. You know, we can hit 300, and that's pretty good, but that also means that we're failing 7 times out of 10. And so it takes mental toughness to persevere through that. And so I think that's something that's unique to our sport as well. And mental health is important because at the end of the day, we're all here trying to be the best versions of ourselves, and we have to be healthy physically and mentally in order to be able to do that. And so what I've seen is our team come closer together, trust each other even more, and develop some tools that we can use on a day-to-day basis to help us get through those challenges, whether they come off the field or on the field. So we've talked about things like visualization, overcoming fear of failure, time management, the importance of sleep and recovery, and all sorts of things kind of on that, under that umbrella of taking good care of ourselves physically but also mentally so we can be at our best.
Something I've seen that's interested me, at least on the social media, is the Bulldog of the Week award that's kind of just now been starting to be given out. What was the origin of that, and does it, is it something that's resonated with the players and feel like they're you know, striving to kind of get that recognition?
Yeah, I actually found out that the Bulldog of the Week award was something that was done in the past in the program, kind of a tradition under previous coach Michelle Cadigan. And so she passed the torch on, provided me with a little special Bulldog trophy that's really neat. It gets displayed on top of the locker of the chosen Bulldog of the Week. And so we thought that it would be a great thing to do this semester through the season, to just provide some momentum and recognition for individuals that are really busting it at practice and standing out, whether it be through their production and performance or whether it's more effort-oriented things, embodying what we stand for. We have a mantra: eat, effort, attitude, teammate. At the end of the day, you know, if we're taking care of those things, then we're becoming better people too. Being a great teammate, always putting forth your best attitude, always giving your best effort. If you do that in softball and in life, then you're going to be more set up for success. And so that's why we live that and we breathe that, and we want to recognize that. But, you know, these first 2 weeks, our Bulldog of the Week have been people that just came back from break on fire, swinging really hot bats. I could tell that they put the time in over break and improved on some things, and we, our coaching staff, wanted to recognize that because it's so easy to go home during break and sit on your butt and not really do much. You know, the weather's cold, you've got holiday stuff going on, you're with your family, it's easy to be lazy. And I'm so proud that I don't think anybody on our team did that. Everybody came back better and improved and really focused in and ready to be here and wanting to be here. And so that's provided us spark, and I'm really excited to just get on the field and get this thing going and see how it goes.